of course for our club members. I guess we'll keep on doing that for the next couple of weeks, but then again, within the summer months, we are going to establish an English-speaking live trading room. That could be me, could be my colleague Frederick, could be Christoph, one of my other trading colleagues as well. So here at Traders Club 24, we are very keen to present our trading strategies to help you, to support you, to become a successful trader. So that's what's on my mind for today. If you do have any questions in between, drop me a quick email, info@tradersclub24.de, and then I'm happy to get back. If you would like to test our trading strategies on your own, on your very own demo account, risk-free demo account, that is what's all about. Yeah, let me know as well. And so we are very open, we are transparent, and we are giving out a free trial for 30 days. So we are not just saying, all right, these are great trading strategies, or have a look at what I did yesterday, or the week before. No, you can try it yourself. Or you can call one of our trading coaches and then you can do a couple of trades yourself. So very easy to understand trading strategies, and again, we are extremely open in that regard. And yeah, have a look yourself. If it suits you, all right, we would happy to take care of your trading. And if you're not happy, so be it. Maybe you have some additional input, what we could change. Maybe it's not the right thing you are looking for. Yeah, talk to us. Let us know what's not ideal for you right now, and then we can have a chat. We can see what we can do in the future. For the time being, we are extremely happy with all our very own trading strategies. So let me open up the chart of the Dow here right now. Currently, the Dow Jones, or it's called US 30, here with my partner broker, US 30 here on the very top, but also on the right-hand side where we see the Swiss box. All right. Yeah, so that's the Dow Jones. In preparation for a good trading day, I would like to show you something just to get a rough idea of what could happen today or what might happen. So looking at the next trading day, at the next week, it's always different, very difficult thing. It's like a weather forecaster, right? I like to be a weather forecaster myself, and I just look out of the window and I see the sun is shining, all right, and if it's raining, and that's pretty much it. I don't know what the weather's going to be like next week, but I don't care. I treat trading very much the same way, as I'm not very much interested in what is the Dow going to do next week or next month. There's so many variables, so many things that can happen. It would drive me insane. I would go nuts to put that all together and to use that for my trading. Instead, I'd rather like to have a look. We see a nice uptrend here. So the uptrend, just for a short period of time. Yesterday, we see here the white candle. The Dow was trading below. Didn't look very good. So maybe a break of the uptrend here. However, and I'm sure you followed the action of the market yesterday. We had an extremely very good trading day. For instance, the Dow close to 600 points upwards, or 2.3% plus. And that's what's important here. So the Dow was closing above the trend line over here. Yeah. So I'm not a big fan. I just mentioned it by looking at the longer time frames. It should give me an idea. On the other side, we had a top here, and if I'm going to to connect all the candles, all the wicks. We do have a, maybe you see it yourself, maybe triangle set up over here. Right, I'm not going to trade on a daily basis with you here in the live trading room. It would be just too boring. Instead, I'm going to have a look at the M1 or at the 5-minute time frame. And as a template, I'm using my Volarbox trading chart. Along with the template, and the template basically just very easy, it tells me where are the big numbers, 25,500, 600, 700, you get the idea, so on and so forth. So very easy chart indeed. We do have the daily pivot. On the top, we have Fibonacci resistance, and on the bottom, of course, the Fibonacci support at some level. There we go. Okay, but what's most interesting here, and by looking at this chart, are the green zones. The green zones are Volar boxes. Volar, short for volatility. And yeah, volatility, volume. And if you are not familiar with our Swiss box strategy, I mean, it's, how can you? But let me just explain it to you in a very short manner. So this is a special add-on. And I'm going to click on this button, and we do have two pending order lines. So the green one is a buy stop order. The red one is a sell stop order. Right. So I'm going to put these pending order lines around the current market price. So I could place it around the current market price, or I could set up a zone, a pending zone, for instance, the green zone. I could set up a pending order here. So once the price runs into that box, into that area, then the buy stop and the sell stop, they will activate themselves. As long as the price is around here, nothing's going to happen. But once the price comes into the pending box, and then we are waiting for a breakout out of this pending box. Same here. So if I'm going to activate it, I need the price to come out of this box. So if it breaks out to the top, we're going to open up a long position. If the price goes down, we are short in the market. Right, once that happens, once we've opened up a trade to either direction, you will see a blue line. The blue line is the take profit line. So the price needs to cross that profit line. And then we're out of the trade. That's it, pretty much, pretty easy stuff. Right, so if the price is going to break out, now that's very important. And it's not going to reach our take profit line, but if the price changes and then drops down and it crosses my red line, at this point of time, the Swiss box will open up a second position in the market. So we are long with the first trade and we are short with the second trade. The blue line instantly drops from here to down here. And then if the price goes over the blue line again, both trades will close out. Yes, the first one with a loss. However, the second one will bring me a profit. The position size of the second trade is always bigger than the first one. Or in general, the position size of the current trade is always larger than the previous one. So for instance, I could go long, short, and then long again, right? So if the price is trading within a very narrow range, it will open up my orders one after the other. And by that, I'm going to have maybe four trades open, maybe five trades, maybe six trades, right? Okay, it's like a bottle of champagne. You need to shake it very well, and then at some point of time, you will experience breakout or the pop. Right, and that's exactly what this trading strategy is all about. So we are looking for specific market situations, conditions, when you can expect that the price is not going to stay at this current market level. One more time. So with this trading strategy, we are not looking to go long or to go, sorry, we are not entering the market at a market order, long or short, like if you're using the RSI, MACD, and so on and so forth. No. We'll have to find specific situations in the chart when you can expect the price to break out to either side. And this is what the Vola box, volume box, is all about. So I know for sure, very confident in that regard, I know for sure that the price, once it goes into this greenish box, it will not stay there. I'm extremely confident about that. Same S&P, same with the NASDAQ, same with the euro dollar, and on all the other markets. So this is a special algorithm which tells me a zone where the price is not going to stay. So for me, that's a perfect trading signal, as I know that I need to place my box around these greenish boxes and then just to wait for the price to leave that box. I don't mind if it's going to go up or down. The prices needs to leave that box, and that's going to happen. Period. Okay, so we do have 1 minute to go for the market opening. That was just a little explanation of our Swiss box trading. So this live trading, we hope will, so it takes approximately half an hour. We'll trade up to around 4 p.m. Central European Standard Time. All right, let's get it done, and we are going to prepare our market orders, because it's not all about these greenish boxes. I know for very, I'm very sure that we can trade the market opening. So let's click on entry on off. So that's the current price. Down here in the trading terminal, you see these pending orders, the green line, the red line. And we'll just wait for 20 seconds for the market opening. Okay, 2-1, and now the US, or the US stock market has opened. Just looking at the markets here, NASDAQ is going up, also the S&P. Where's the Dow? It's not, bit sluggish here. So we are not only looking at the green boxes, at the Vola boxes, but there are actually three different situations when you can use this box trading. Three different situations. And one situation we are just looking at, or just experiencing, is we know exactly when there's some market movement going on, and it's going on when the markets are open. So we are looking at the German DAX market opening, which is going to happen, or which is happening every day at 9 a.m. sharp. So at this point of time, you know, all right, now you can trade all these different shares like Bayer, Allianz, Wirecard, maybe you've heard of them. Very re interesting trading stock over the last couple of days. I'm not going to into detail, but oh boy, this is one crazy investment or crazy company. I'm not very proud of it, but yeah. So it was trading like at 100 euro last week. Then they filed for administration. The price was going down to a euro. And today it was, I think I heard that correctly, it was trading from 1 euro back to 10 euro. So tenfold. Okay. So 9 a.m. Sorry about that. 9 a.m. There's always some action going on in the market. That's for sure. Same with the American markets. At 3:30 every day, we know that there will be some volatility. And if I'm looking at the DAX on the right-hand side, there is certainly some volatility going on here. DAX a little bit. However, the Dow Jones is extremely, very muted this morning. So now we are in the first trade, right? So you can see the prices went up above the green line, and here's the blue line. That's our take profit. So usually the price would be closed out once it triggers the blue line. I can manually adjust my take profit line. So if I'm a bit greedy, I could say, all right, let's go into my way. And so it's not going to be close out at this level. I want to have a couple more bucks over here. Just looking at the S&P on the right-hand side. So you see a lot of volatility going on, and we can place another pending order around this level. Right. Price down here, entry on off. And real quick, we are short in the first trade. Price of the Nasdaq needs to come below the blue line. So that's the reason why I love the market opening. So there's always a lot of volatility going on. So extremely interested for the market opening. And down we go. So we are out of the Nasdaq. Good stuff over here. Just a second example. Again, we are clicking on the button, blue lines on off. We can enlarge the box if you like. You can bring it down by a couple of points. I would suggest to trade the Nasdaq. Yeah, 3 to 5 points. That's the ideal box size. Entry on again. And we are long in the first trade. Needs to go above the blue line, and we are out of it again. So back to the 10,000 point mark. What is my friend Dow Jones doing here? I might have been out of the trade by crossing the dotted line. So far, we are still in that trade. It says here, first trade. Don't worry, by the way, about these, relative small profits. So I'm using a trading account with 10K on it, and my risk settings, they're extremely, extremely low. So right now, the price is above my regular take profit, so I would be already out of the market. By the way, you can click on this button, close out at any point of time. And then, of course, you're closing that trade with a market order. I'm going to do that once the price comes back, because I don't want to let this winning trade back into a negative position, as you might understand. And that's it. We are out of our trades right now. And just look at the number, 25,600. That's a big number. And we call it a big number trade, obviously. So we are usually placing our box lines around this price level. So the mid price of the box is exactly on that round number. However, in this particular setting, I'm going to prefer this trade. So I'm going to activate that right now. It says pending box on the right hand side. So once the price goes into the Bollinger box, then the box will be activated. As long as the price is staying down here, nothing is going to happen. So pending box on the left, and there's some in the NASDAQ as well. And To be honest, that's a market movement I've. So entry on. That's something I haven't expected. All right. See, you'll never know what the markets are going to do. Box lines, NASDAQ. Ten-point box over here, and we're saying entry on off. So again, on the left-hand side, a pending box. The S&P, it's already trading in the green box, and on the right-hand side, we are looking at a big number trade of the NASDAQ at the magic number of 10,000 points. And let's see how these trades. See how that's going long in the first trade here. All right. So the NASDAQ, so NASDAQ in that trade, the Dow Jones, still a bit muted. Just going to enlarge this chart. So just before the market opening, so the futures markets, dropped by 100 points. I haven't seen any evidence why this happened. So actually the market is still trading at a decent level, I would say. So not extremely looking bullish or bearish. So we are in a very much in a sideways market, so to speak. Actually, within different time frames. And so this is a triangle we were looking at a bit earlier on the for our candlestick chart here. Okay, so the NASDAQ it's long, we are short in the S&P, and so far the DAX is sorry, not the DAX. The Dow Jones is doing anything. We'll have to keep a couple of things in mind. Some news announcement. I think it's going to be very interesting. So important news announcement. We do have a consumer confidence index coming out in approximately 20 minutes. So that's always an announcement, an important announcement, where we can see some additional volatility going on. So it definitely has an impact of the market. We'll never know if the numbers are good or bad. I think, who does? But at least the market will show us some response to these numbers. Looking at the, thank you, out of the DAX, well above the 10,000 point mark. All the tech stocks are performing extremely well. Any other indication? So we do have a green pending box over here, which is also in line with the new daily high. And these are especially the kind of setups I like very much. So whenever I'm going to complete that thought with all the three different situations, but I like just trading the box when the market is trading at a new daily high or daily low. So if that signal is aligned with the green box, so be it. Definitely a good setup here. However, we would ask the NASDAQ to cover like 20, 30 points to reach that green trading zone. I was going to mention the, oh, okay. So no box line on the very top, instead. So I'm just clicking on close. So if the markets are not going to go up, maybe the Dow wants to turn a bit more bearish. So I need to be flexible here with my trading, and instead of trading the box above, I'm maybe waiting for another short entry here. Consumer confidence coming out in a couple of minutes, and we do have Mr. Powell, the US Fed chef, having a press conference today at 6:30, again European Central time. So that's another very important point of time during the trading day when you have some additional volatility picking up. Not that we need the volatility, it's already above average over the last couple of weeks and months. So very, very interesting trading times. It's like having Christmas and birthday all on the same day, and this same day it's going on for a couple of months now. So lots of different trading setups here, which we are of course appreciating very much. But when Mr. Powell is speaking, so there will be some extra volatility coming in. I was reading the newspaper earlier today, and he already mentioned that he's very pleased with the with the market movement of the stock markets during the last couple weeks. So it looks like the stock markets have digested the corona shock, all these bad numbers. Very, very good. And some say too good. And some even mentioned that there has been a decoupling between the stock markets and the real economy. So the real economy is still fighting, it's shrinking. The GDP is going down in almost all G20 countries. No, in all, not in almost all, but in all G20 countries. But the stock markets, they are back at levels where it was close before the corona. The exception is the US NASDAQ, where I'm just looking here at the daily chart. So we are trading at all-time high, regardless of corona or COVID-19. It's a bit odd. Decoupling here, and so here's our green box. We are placing our pending order lines around this level, and I'm already going to click on entry on off. Right, so far nothing will happen as long as the price is not going to enter here in this particular range. Okay, so we came out with the first trade here in the S&P. If the market is going to re-enter this greenish box, then yeah, we can do another trade. From my point of view, it's not as strong as a signal as the first one. However, it's still an okay signal. So let's activate the box. So the first signal, of course, is always the strongest. And then the second, the third, the fourth, maybe not so much. And so I know from Carlos, and he's always trading at least the first and the second signal, so that's what I'm going to do here right now. We are short in the first trade, and let me click on my custom target down here, so we can adjust our take profit line just slightly. And I think by now you've yeah, you get the idea of trading these small impulses, and then once a trade, oh, you know, short and long in the same market. So that what I was talking about earlier. Yeah, so I like to get into the trades very early, and then if the market has a specific setup, I would like to let the markets run. So by run, I mean I have to click on custom and adjust my blue line again. So sometimes it makes sense, sometimes it doesn't. And I'm telling you, when it doesn't make sense, it doesn't make sense if the market is trading within a sideways range. However, it does make sense when, you know, again, that the price is currently trading within a very certain chart pattern, head and shoulder, triangle, all that stuff, a double bottom, double top. So when you're getting into the trade with a Swiss box at these specific chart patterns and you just get stopped in your trade, and then it makes sense to adjust your take profit line. Same with the daily high, daily low, it goes for the weekly as well. So for the real market opening, like in Germany, 9 a.m. or 3:30 in the US, I like to get out of the trades real quick. So NASDAQ here on the right. But if you are going to put your placing, but if you're going to put your pinning order lines at a daily high or low, which I'm just going to do right here, then clicking entry on off, price needs to go back into the line. So then obviously it makes sense to adjust your take profit and to let the trades run a little bit. Yeah, you're not want to become greedy, but I mean a couple of bucks here and now, yeah, it makes a bit more fun. Okay, so again, NASDAQ, we are out of that trade. By the way, let me show you all the different trades. These are my trades from early morning, trading the DAX. And we are out of this one. So with a MetaTrader, you can S&P. Yeah, with a MetaTrader, you can visualize your trades here in the chart right away. So US 100. Yeah, let's zoom in. And now on the left hand side, the Dow Jones, and close to a second entry on the short side. So it's not quite a new daily low. The future prices tended to trade around 25,440 point mark. However, 1, 2, 3, and maybe, yeah, so a third time that line is going to be tested, and yeah, could be a nice impulse to the short side. But I was showing the other trades to you. So we do have yeah, all these entry and exit arrows here on the side, and you can just drag and drop them into the chart, like this one. And this one with all the different markets. Now the Dow Jones. All right, here we go. Nice breakout to the bottom. And I'm going to adjust my take profit line, at least to be ready to adjust my take profit line. Keep in mind, you can always trade. You can always close the trades by clicking on this purple button here. So let's bring it back and yeah. All right, there's one thing I haven't shown you yet. And oh, sorry, press the one button. Swissbox. I see. All right. I need to put that tool back into the chart and I need to adjust my magic number. There we go. Yeah, so you can actually put that Swissbox add-on on any chart. And if you would like to go, I mean, you, sorry for that chair, needs to be oiled. So you can place a pending box above the current chart and below the current chart. And by that, you just need to have a second chart. So I could have three charts of the Dow Jones here in the MetaTrader, or four or five. And every time I'm going to put that add-on into the chart, the magic number needs to be adjusted. Yeah, no big deal. Here we are back again. So far, the Dow Jones, bit tricky this afternoon. So there's no clear indication of where it's heading today. 6 minutes time, it's going to be the consumer confidence. We are definitely going to trade this one, that I can tell you. Okay, sorry, yeah, but I want to show you something I haven't done yet. Let me see. Yeah, that's the one. It's called Trade Radar. Trade Radar is a scanner, a market scanner, automatic market scanner. And the nice thing is that it displays the trading signals automatically. So first, you need to open up all these different markets down here. And in every market, you are going to add the special algorithm in it or the special indicator in it. And once you've done that, the Trade Radar recognizes, where's my Trade Radar? There it goes. It recognizes whenever a market, doesn't matter if it's a dollar cut, Aussie dollar, euro dollar, you name it, oil, gold. So whenever the market is going to enter a greenish box, you will see a yellow signal here on the left hand side, and you can also enable an acoustic signal. Right, so if you're working, if you have the focus on your trading chart the whole time, at least you hear something on your headset. So that's definitely a nice thing to do. You can add up to 8 markets here on the left hand side into the market scanner, and all it does is scan the markets with every single tick. So right now I'm getting an entry signal here in the cable. Right, so the market is in the box. Yeah. So I can do that trade here right now, no problem. But you see that, so we already had to do that trade, and the trade was breaking out to the top very sharply trade. And now it's just a second entry signal. So the signal which I'm now going to trade is not as strong as the first signal. All right, just to keep that in mind. Yeah, so you can add up all the markets here. You see on the top left corner how many pending boxes there are, how many boxes are active, how many boxes have been closed, and so on and so forth. So that's the Trade Radar Volar box. By the way, we also have a Trade Radar for our blue box. We have a Trade Radar for our trading strategy and also for the day trading strategy. So it just makes trading a little bit more easier. Yeah, so you don't necessarily need to have it because you can set up everything down here in the charts and you can switch all the different time frame. You can open up new charts, you can close a chart. But to be honest, it makes trading a lot more easier here. All right, markets are up again in that box, and again. Let me try it again. Position side. All right. So another trade here in the S&P. Oh, must have been the wrong market. Sorry, Bose is a NASDAQ here. And with one trade, we are short in the NASDAQ. And with the other one, we are long in the NASDAQ. No problem. But ideally, I would have been trading the S&P. Someone must have changed the chart here. Anyhow, so let's bring up my trading terminal down here. So you can see I'm not doing actually a lot. The Swiss box does all the work for me. So it closes up a new trade. It will automatically open up an opposite trade. And I just need to preset my pending order lines. So the green and the red line, these are the adjustments I have to make and just to wait for the right market situation. That's pretty much all there is. Yeah, that's all there is. And wait for some volatility. Okay, bottom right corner of each single chart, there are still 40 seconds, 30 seconds to go for the news announcement of the consumer confidence. So I'm happy to see that my NASDAQ long trade is out with a profit, of course. Just waiting for the other markets to react to that announcement. 15 seconds to go. All right, there we go. So let's quickly start my economic calendar again. So I'm not seeing numbers yet. Markets, however, is already reacting. So the NASDAQ on the right, we are long in the second trade. You can see that here. Second trade long. And yeah, come on, Dow Jones. What's wrong with you today? Seriously, we are looking at the M5 time frame. And yeah, just compare the market movement between the NASDAQ and the blue chips. Wow. And so that's a huge mismatch between the performance of these two. Still owe you the numbers of the consumer confidence. It's not showing up. Even though it's already a minute, 2 minutes after the announcement. Yeah, it's a problem with these websites. They're just not updating the numbers appropriately. Okay, so the Dow has triggered our take profit. Good stuff. And what about the NASDAQ here on the right? All right. Not yet. However, we just entered our trade in the cable. I'm going to show you in a couple of moments. Just one or two more points for the NASDAQ to get out of, to get us out of this trade. So I'm just having a look at our website. So there's an economic calendar. It's, see, the number is still updating here. Same on the on the other websites, FX3 and so on. Yeah. So news trading can be a little bit tricky if you don't do not get the news accordingly, or within the right time. And just by looking Bloomberg, for instance, doesn't help at all, because there is there's a delay if you're going to watch it over the internet. Anyhow, so yeah. Here's an NASDAQ, and we are quickly going to check on our trade at the or in the cable at the cable. Not sure. That's one. So the pound US dollar needs to go up. We are first, or with our first trade, we are long in the market. Yeah, these are the trades. I'd like to show you how the S&P will leave the market for today, but I'm pretty sure you can. Let us open up a new trade here on the red line, another sell stop order, which is, by the way, already waiting down here. So down here, these are the next pending orders placed by the Swiss box. But I don't want to keep you waiting for too long. Let's just get into the cable. So we are long here, close to the take profit line. Right, you can see it here nicely. All right, out of this trade. Great, and last trade for today. So that's not the one. Yeah. Yeah, sorry. So I don't want to keep you waiting. I'm sure you got a good understanding of how this Swiss box strategy works. Keep in mind that it's not the only strategy we are offering to our club members, but it's the most active one. That's for sure. So if you like to have some action, if you like to have some entertainment, this Swissbox strategy is definitely the one with an extremely high hit rate of 99%. That's fair to say. And it's so yeah, it's total opposite to any trend following strategy where you have to wait for the signals, and you need to let the trades run. If you've missed the signal because you were shopping at Tesco, or Walmart, whatever, you need to wait again for a signal. That can be a little bit frustrating from time to time and all that. With that open range short out, with that open range breakout trading on this extremely short term time frame on the M1, M time, M1, M5, or M15. It really depends on which chart you would like to look at. Yeah, it's much more interesting, and so it's fun to trade actually. Come on, Nasdaq. What are you going to do? Maybe open up a second. So we are now short in the market with the Nasdaq, and let's see how that goes. All right, if you would like to make your own trading experience with these trading strategy, let me know. Drop me an info at drop me an email at info@tradersclub24.de. My name is Christian. Thanks very much for watching. Right now, maybe on the top side again, the Nasdaq. And yeah, we'll be happy to assist you with setting up a demo account and all these different trading strategies on your PC. 10,050 point mark. So it's trading at a new daily high. Let's see where is the next resistance in the chart. Oh, it's pretty much empty space all over. Yeah. Again, I don't want to keep you waiting. So have a great day. Wish you all the best, and I hope to see you back again the next couple of days here on our YouTube or Facebook live streaming channel, or maybe you get access to our very own live trading room right away. Have a great day. Bye bye.